Welcome to the Business of Travel, the official podcast of the Global Business Travel Association. I'm Ben Park, chair of the GBTA Europe Advisory Board, and I'll be your host for today's episode. IATA's new distribution capability, NDC, is certainly a hot topic in corporate travel once again. Following the rollout of some airline NDC programs in Europe with British Airways, Lufthansa, Air France, KLM, NDC is now advancing in the US. United Airlines are running a pilot program, and American Airlines have announced their own program, which will launch in April. While many TMCs and OBTs claim to support NDC, the depth of NDC capabilities can vary considerably. On today's episode, I'm asking two very, very experienced travel buyers to share their experiences with us and how they are preparing and have prepared already for the evolution of airline distribution and what corporates can do to ensure their travel program is NDC ready. With no further ado, I'm so delighted to introduce Rita, Director of Global Travel Sourcing and GPO at Oracle, and Carlos, Global Procurement Service Leader Travel at Cisco. Welcome to you both. Good. Let me go to Rita, who's usually not as shy as now, to ask the first question. As an industry, we are progressive and always looking for a better retailing experience and savings for our travelers. So what do you think are the benefits or should have been the benefits of NDC?
Thanks, Ben. I've been a staunch supporter of NDC for a long time because of the benefits that we'll see from it. Benefits like a consumer shopping experience, the ability to have the traveler give a more improved shopping experience, bringing them offers that are tailored to them, which I think are important. And then from a procurement perspective, I also have the opportunity to negotiate bundles that make sense for my travelers out of different regions, maybe different levels within the organization that might need something differently. NDC, as we know it down the road, we believe those are going to be some of the benefits.
Thank you. And good to hear that there are really benefits standing out and what makes sense to buyers. So turning it into the other side of the coin, Carlos, if I'm allowed to ask, like, what do you think are the challenges buyers might face with the introduction of NDC?
Thank you, Ben. Yes, I mean, some wonderful benefits as Rita outlined, but the reality is the access of NDC content may not all be there. The readiness of these products that are being made available, every carrier is at a different stage. So being able to see all those products is definitely a gap that we are seeing at this point. The proof of NDC advantages, you know, hasn't really been, you know, truly tested. The NDC content needs to work through multiple components. The impact that it's having on our TMC tech resources because of the change that this required, it means that, you know, technology needs to be tested. So that's really a constraint on our TMC. And then finally, increased costs. More products doesn't necessarily mean, you know, it's free. So really managing the available products that are going to be distributed are definitely going to play a part in the role of the travel manager, as that's a responsibility that we have in managing costs for our organizations.
Thank you. Thank you. And we'll go into detail on a few challenges and how to overcome this in later questions. But using Rita, who can always explain everything to me like I'm a five-year-old, I've got one question for you. So there are still some confusions around NDC and many buyers are looking to better understand the requirements for NDC and how to consume the content and how to be NDC ready. So explain to me, like you would do to a five-year-old, like what are the differences in the future between a traditional GDS airfare booking flow and an NDC booking flow?
Well, thanks for the five-year-old reference, Ben. I'll start by saying the old moniker, NDC does not, NDC, is a new distribution channel. It does not mean not direct connect, right? It is not direct connect. So there is a difference between the two. So let's start with EDIFACT. EDIFACT is that traditional GDS, kind of that storefront that the GDS offers. We all know that, GDS brings forward information that on fares, et cetera. There's some limitations with the GDS and how fares are loaded right now, which is why NDC is necessary. So that I think everybody understands. Those out there who are saying, oh my goodness, like how do I set up all these, direct content APIs? The good news about the industry as it is today is starting or by April 1st, the major GDSs, including Sabre, Amadeus, and Travelport will all have NDC in them. So it isn't like somebody's going to have to go out and set up a direct connect. That information will be available in the GDS. Honestly, I have access to the GDS. I can see NDC content in there now for carriers across the globe. So that I think that's the one thing that people are thinking about, like, oh my goodness, I have a whole separate, pipe that I need to build or pipe that I need to enable. The GDSs are going to allow us to do that. The difference in those, quite honestly, is the EDIFACT content is processed as normal through a GD, through a TMC. TMC is, it has all those service capabilities ready. And we're going to talk about some of the challenges. So service is going to come up. The NDC content that sits in the GDS, really that one of the major differences is when you issue a ticket, for instance, and I'm not even going to say an airline because someone will say, oh, wait a second, you didn't mention us. When you issue a ticket with the airline through an NDC content, that airline issues that ticket. There isn't a loss of control there by any stretch of the imagination. There isn't a loss of duty of care. There's just, it's different in how the ticket is processed. Some OBTs are going to be able to show you NDC content. Some aren't ready for that. So the major difference is how does that content come in? So I don't know that I necessarily answered the question. And Ben, I think you know me well enough to know that this is generally something I'd sit down and show you almost on a piece of paper, but it's hard to do on a podcast. But I would tell, I think trying to summarize this, and not because I treat you as a five-year-old, Ben. But I think one of the challenges, in really understanding it is people are thinking, oh my goodness, there's all of these different pipes that I need to create. Know that the GDS partners are doing that on your behalf. And then it just comes down to how do you get the content in front of your travelers? Did that help to answer your question, Ben?
Absolutely, and thank you. And the picture I have now from what you laid out is basically the search and book might be easier as we all think. The challenges come after that point in the process where NDC on servicing, on stuff is more complicated. But people shouldn't be too concerned about the search and book in the future. Thank you. And let me stay with you for a follow-up question on this. So how do you know if you're NDC ready? So what kind of questions, as we already talked about servicing, what kind of questions should you be asking your TMC in specific at the moment or should have been asked already?
We are recording this on the 24th. We're, a week and a couple of days from go live. These questions should be coming up already. Like we are running tests almost on a daily basis with our TMC partner. We are looking at PNR, NDC versus EDIFAC PNRs kind of up against one another. We're understanding like what reporting fields are coming over, all of those things. So there's that piece of it. That's all your back office stuff. Those service capabilities are going to be different, no question. And here's where, you know, I feel for the TMC environment. The TMC environment doesn't know what, we all don't know what we don't know, let's be really clear. But the TMC environment is trying to prepare for something that they don't know and fully understand yet. For instance, like, oh my goodness, seat assignments aren't going to happen. So now, how does the agent, does the agency solve for that? Does the traveler solve for that directly? How does the traveler know they should solve for that if they don't see the difference there? So the conversations, you know, that most TMCs are willing and ready to have with you right now is, here's what we believe is going to be the difference, starting, you know, like with any NDC carrier. It is, you know, we're talking about here in the US, that some major changes that are happening in April. But let's be clear, NDC content is already out there and available across Europe. So my guess is some of them are already having those conversations. It just feels like a larger topic now because there's a deadline that seems to be looming. And so if we're talking about that deadline that's out there and looming, it is about having conversations maybe about that one specific carrier that's saying, how is this going to be serviced? And again, I would tell anybody that's listening, your TMCs are diving into this. It's time for you to have a conversation so you understand the service differential, the experience differential for your travelers. I always say, you know, something in the background of this, a traveler should never know or understand, was it EDIFAC or NDC content? Because they should get the same service. The call to action is to have that conversation to say, in order so my traveler is not impacted, what do we collectively, the TMC and the corporation, need to do? The TMC on the servicing side and possibly the corporation on the communication side.
Absolutely, thank you. And I think you pointed out really well that a lot of the things cannot be prepared by TMC before it's really live. So I think what you said is basically increase the communication now and further increases after your NDC channel is live to then adjust really quickly once you realize real impacts. And what I heard as well is the servicing aspect is around reshopping, rebooking, around seat assignments. These are things which travelers assume as a given, but it's for the TMCs in an NDC environment really different, and sometimes depending on the airline, also very difficult to keep up the same service levels, correct?
Yeah. So I think the one thing that's possibly, you know, and I agree with everything you said there, Ben. I think the one thing that, I would just say that warrants another conversation is, this isn't new, right? And I just said that there has been airlines throughout Europe and throughout Asia Pac, for example, that have NDC content. So if the fact that right now your TMC is only looking at this saying, oh, I have to solve for this now, they've had some opportunities where they could go in and you know, run some tests historically, and maybe they haven't. So right now is crunch period, by all means. You know, it's too late to look back and say, well, we should have been doing this a long time ago now. But I would say that some of those capabilities have existed.
Yeah, thank you. Carlos, so if we're talking about the TMC questions, specifically to the OBT, what would be the questions you recommend other buyers to ask the TMC regarding the online booking tool or tools you're using?
Yeah, Ben, I think, you know, what I think is out there is, you know, how do you know if you're NDC ready? So, you know, asking the TMC the right questions, as you've just heard from Rita, is key. As I mentioned earlier, there's three components in this new journey that we're all entering, you know, GDS, TMC, and then as many of us over the years have really pushed our online booking tools, OBTs, you know, to be the first kind of, you know, entry point for our travelers. We need to be asking those questions around the market to market and regional differences. Some of us may have global programs like myself, and the landscape is very different when you go from the US to LATAM to EMEA to Asia Pacific. So really understanding the differences within the regional aspect is going to be key. The maturity levels are going to be different in each region. So I think that's going to be key as you sort of talk around the online booking tool. I think understanding, as you ask those questions with your TMCs, who actually, you know, fulfill and support a number of OBTs out there, I think it's going to be key to get their positioning on it as well, because you will hear a view from the OBTs in terms of their readiness levels. But again, you know, as travel buyers, it's instrumental that we understand that these components work seamlessly together. Because at the end of the day, whether you book online or book offline, everything comes into one sort of repository, which does multiple things from experience to duty of care, et cetera, et cetera. How the OBT works with the GDS, the OBTs often and can today, and this isn't new, work with aggregators, which aren't necessarily, you know, the GDS itself. Many of us are already utilizing aggregators outside of the GDS for what is known as low-cost carriers. So in EMEA, you have carriers such as Ryanair and EasyJet. In Asia Pacific, you have some carriers in India like Indigo, Vistara, and carriers as such, where they may not necessarily be coming through the traditional GDS channels today. But those questions that you should be asking yourself is really, you know, if the OBT is going outside of the traditional channels, are those channels going to allow your program, your travelers to be serviced seamlessly as they are today when they're booking through the traditional GDS channel? Some of you out there may have systems or tools like pre-trip approval, which we do in our program. And you've got to also factor that in, because there may be elements or scenarios where that isn't feasible. So again, you need to be asking those questions with your TMC. If we turn on this, if we enable this, you know, new distribution content, which sounds great, you know, more products, you know, better experience, but what's the implications of, you know, what I'm trying to do, which is manage, you know, a lot of people coming through the booking channel, policy, duty of care. So I think there's definitely key questions when you think about your online booking tool. Factor in the regional differences, factor in your own program, your own policies, what your goals and your strategy is. You know, what are you driving with your leadership, your stakeholders? I think it's really key to ensure that the OBTs that may say that they can do a lot more may actually be detrimental to your current program and what you're trying to achieve. So I think there needs to be synergy between these components that we reference, you know, whether it be GDS, OBT, and obviously the TMC. We want our employees to continue to have that great experience, but also enhancing it as we move along. Okay, Ben?
Yeah, thank you.
And Carlos, summarized.
Go ahead, Rita.
Carlos, I would just add one thing to that, if I could, Ben. So Carlos mentioned, you know, aggregators, for example, and I think there are folks out there saying, we can bring this content into you through another solution. And I think bringing the content in through another solution into an OBT is, you know, I think people look at it and go, tick in the box, that's done. There are implications to those challenges as well that, you know, you need to fully understand. So, you know, and it isn't just like if an OBT can say, yeah, we can bring you all this content, we're good. You have to understand, where is that content coming from and how does that service differential look?
Yeah, good point, Rita. And just very quickly, Ben. Yeah, don't lose sight of aggregators will definitely enable. They're not new. They've been around, but we've experienced that they are a different channel that bring different challenges to your program, and also costs. Just be aware of that as well. That there's often another cost to enable some of those, which in some cases you have to because of low cost carrier kind of architecture. But again, it's a really good point, Rita. We need to be cautious of that, especially. So just my final point, Ben, is how do you know if you're NDC ready? I think we're all sitting here, and I don't think any of us know if we're truly NDC ready, whether it's us, the corporate buyer, or the TMCs or the GDSs. So I just want to make sure that point is clear, that I think we're all on this journey. We're all learning together. And being NDC ready is a great question. I'm not sure someone can really sit there and say, yeah, I'm NCC ready. So don't feel overwhelmed that you're sitting there. But definitely learn more. Definitely take on all this information and work closely with the respective partners that you have in your programs. Thanks, Ben.
Yeah, thank you both. I mean, very valid points to remind buyers on evaluating the pros and cons of plugging in additional services, using an aggregator. And then on the other side, Carlos, what you mentioned so well is look at all your experiences. You have now consistently your pre-approvals, your payment stuff. So if you then look at the overall picture, what is maybe more important for the company overall? So yeah, maybe a good slight warning, and don't get too hang up on quickly agreeing to everything on an OBT change, on an aggregator plugin, just to get the content. Think about it by all the other items. So I think a very good reminder to just evaluate the full picture. As we are now already in the more strategic questions, I have a question for you both. So as travel buyers have supplier strategies, and in the past, there was this, oh, let's do an airline strategy, a hotel sourcing strategy. Then every, 3 years, you did your TMC RFP or something. So do you see now with the introduction of NDC to US and the where it is in Europe already? So it might reach now a certain point where, do you think this influences the procurement strategy going forward? And Carlos, maybe starting with you.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to answer that question. So the answer is yes. I mean, the whole landscape has changed, and we knew it would with what we've experienced over the last 2 to 3 years. So, how we look at our what I call subcategories, airlines, hotels, car, ground, agency, card payment solutions, I think it is different. And so it has changed. And so when we look at our strategies, we need to be thinking technology distribution is now becoming, a component of our whole strategy, whether that be airlines in this situation. We need to be considering, how that distribution will play into our discussions and our negotiations when we're talking to our airline partners. So it's absolutely changed. And we've talked a bit about this, there's these elements of GDS, OBT, TMC. So I think when we look at our strategies, and definitely for myself, it's almost like, I look at distribution being extremely key to the future of our travel programs. And, it's not pinpointing on just one of those elements, but it's bringing it in as part of your kind of, travel programs of the future. So absolutely, there's definitely changes, which is constant now in the role of what we're all doing today, which is exciting. I just want to throw that in. Over to you, Rita.
and for Rita, I've got a provocative question to answer as well with the other one. So while you're getting prepared to answer also for the procurement strategy, if you can answer as well in there, is basically your airline strategy dictating the rest of your basically ecosystem going forward? Thank you.
Yeah, So let me answer the first question first. Yes, the entire ecosystem is changing. So if, you know, if corporate travel was new and you today were saying, I'm going to create a new strategy for my airline, for my airline sourcing that sits on top of a GDS and, you know, serviced by an OBT and then serviced, again, fully then by a TMC. If someone could white slate that, today would be the environment to do that in. The challenge is most of us in corporate travel and in managed travel have an existing platform that we're already on. And the pain of change and the time to make the changes does take a long time, right? So the panacea would be, I'm starting fresh in a brand new role and I don't have any other ties to anything. That's a program that's set to change the world. That isn't a reality that most of us live in today. When you do think about, again, looking at your airline strategy, now all of a sudden you have to look at it and go, oh, wait a second, I'm having a conversation with ABC. They are distributing content only through EdiFact. That ties to my OBT and my TMC relationship. I'm having a conversation with an airline that has both an EdiFact and an NDC, shopping path that, changes all of those conversations. So yes, absolutely. And then Ben, the second piece is the airline strategy and is the airline sourcing right now really driving those other decisions? Yes. Is hotel distribution sitting back and watching this and saying, wait a second, how can we do this more effectively? For sure. Are the TMCs and the OBTs worried about hotels right now? I think it's probably in the back of their mind on, wait a second, what could happen with this, with hotel distribution down the path? Many hotels have been talking about direct connect solutions, et cetera, for a long time. They haven't talked about that through the OBT environment, but could they? For sure. So the answer to both of those questions is absolutely.
Thanks. Good. And to wrap us up, a final question to you both with a very quick answer, please, is as experienced buyers, what would be your number one advice to a buyer who's been listening now and says, oh my God, I need to do something. Where should they start? Carlos, maybe you go first.
Yeah, I think the first place is if you're, you know, you ought to think about servicing. You wanted a quick answer. It's not always a quick answer, but I would say you need to look at your partners, and that's your TMC is instrumental. Is if they're, you know, managing your programs today, servicing your programs today, it's key that you start, you know, engaging early on their capabilities, because there's a huge impact on servicing that you need to factor in here. So I would definitely start looking at TMC partnerships and trying to gauge, you know, their position. Where are they in this journey? Because everybody is in different phases of the journey. So I would definitely understand where are they in the journey and get some insights. So that would be my advice at this point is start with the TMC. You'll get information from airlines, you've got information from your technology partners, but ultimately at the end of the day, all of this content is being fulfilled and serviced through your travel management partner. So I think that's a good starting point.
Thank you. Rita?
I wouldn't disagree. Carlos kind of stole my answer. So I'm going to go back to the, you know, we talked about the word ready. How many people said, oh my goodness, I'm ready to have a child. And then that first or second or fifth night that you're up at midnight going, I really wasn't ready for this, right? I don't think anybody's ready for dramatic change ever. You know, there's a progression of readiness. It's looking at the ecosystem around you, looking at your support system, right? In having a child, it's your spouse or it's, you know, who's going to be there to support you. I would say it's very similar in this. have a conversation with those that are going to support you through the change, which to Carlos's point is the TMC. You need to understand from them what's going to look different. What day is it going to look different? How is the service going to look different? How is the reporting going to look different? It feels a little too late at this point, but those conversations are still key and should still be happening.
Yeah.
Thank you both. This was really, really insightful. And thank you for really answering here all these questions in details and helping other buyer colleagues to understand better how to start with this. So there are clearly a lot of factors for buyers to consider it around this subject. So as GBTA members, there are plenty of discussions on the GBTA Hub, and I encourage you to actively participate on this channel to continue and ask and collaborate. So you have been listening to the Business of Travel, the official podcast of the Global Business Travel Association. For more information about GBTA and its work, visit gbta.org and be sure to rate and review us where you got your podcast. Until next time. Thanks for listening and good luck with your NDC strategy.